We're so used to seeing you with Rob in these settings. What's it like doing this kind of stuff when he's not here?
Yeah, I miss him. I miss him. Last couple of months have been a challenge. I think whenever you lose somebody who you care dearly about and spent a lot of time with and been through some rough patches with, it hurts. But also know he wanted everybody to live their life and to get on with things, and to be here today to talk about probably the final thing we did together is pretty special.
They were teammates on the rugby pitch, and for the last 4 years of Rob Burrow's life, he and Kevin Sinfield fought for those, like Rob, suffering with motor neurone disease. Moments like this, at the end of the Leeds Marathon, testament to an extraordinary friendship, one that, before Rob's death, they turned into a children's book.
What is the story? Tell us what the book is and what the message is.
The book is about two little boys, Rob and Kevin, who are exploring what a hero is to them, but then work out that actually heroes aren't always the biggest, strongest, and they don't have to wear a cape. They're actually the people who are around us every day, who care about us, who support us, who love us. You know, Rob certainly was my hero, and how courageous and brave he was throughout that 4.5 years in particular. You know, he just inspired me to be a better person.
What do you think you learned about friendship over particularly that 4.5 years?
It was being the first part of my life where somebody's been struck down with something like that, and to learn how important it is to be there. No matter how tough it gets, no matter how hard it is to see at times, to still show up.
And everyone's so proud of you. Can I help you following your case?
What do you think his legacy is?
His legacy will last forever. He's shown us what living looks like in the toughest and most difficult of circumstances. And when I think about him, my overriding memory is to see Rob smiling. Even the last time I saw him, 2 days before he passed, when I walked into the room, I was greeted with a big smile, and he weren't in a great spot. But he found the strength and the energy and the courage to still show, and what a great way to live.
Greg Milam, Sky News.